Okay, so we're in the water cube with Biomass. Can you please show us your badge? And yeah, tell us, who are you and what are you doing here at this Congress?
I'm Biomass Tal. I'm the Executive Secretary of the African Ministers' Council on Water. That is, all the 54 ministers of water in Africa have a council. Uh-huh. And to coordinate their activity, it's a platform for policy development on water and sanitation. And I'm the Executive Secretary in my capacity as the former Water Minister of Gambia.
Okay. And that sounds like hard work, getting all the people to work together and collaborate. How is it going?
It is very difficult because every country do have their political issues. Mm-hmm. Now trying to harmonize their policies is not easy. Mm-hmm. In Africa you have about 60 river basins, mm-hmm. transboundary waters, and you need to collaborate. If you have a river passing through four countries, yeah. The upper basin need to collaborate with the lower basins. Mm-hmm. And we try to coordinate that. Mm-hmm. We try to make sure that in Africa everybody do have access to clean drinking water. Mm-hmm. At present, 340 million Africans do not have access to water. Mm-hmm. About 500 million Africans do not have access to sanitation. Mm-hmm. We have the MDGs ahead of us, mm-hmm. to reduce it by half by 2015.
Yeah.
And we are not doing that well. In water, only 26 countries are on track to meet the MDGs.
Okay.
In sanitation, only 6 are on track.
It's a lot of work to be done.
Yes, so we need to focus on those countries that are off track to bring them on track. And mm. these countries are mainly countries that are fragile states, mm. post-conflict countries in okay. Africa. Mm. And also, you know, the economic growth in Africa is so slow. So to put budgetary allocation that is enough to bring water on top is very difficult.
Yeah.
So we are trying to get the Minister of Finance to understand the non-investment on water, how it impacts negatively on the economy.
Yeah, because how it's more expensive in the long run.
Yeah, it's going to be more expensive because we have done studies that non-investment on water will bring your GDP about up to 10%.
Hmm.
Non-investment on sanitation up to 12%. So if you invest in water, so you can bring your GDP high up. In Africa, about 60% of the hospital beds are occupied by patients with waterborne diseases.
Mm.
So you need to do prevention rather than cure. So if you invest in water, you are reducing your medical
expenses. Bill. Yeah.
Yeah. So these are all issues that faces Africa.
Mm-hmm.
And for me and the organization to coordinate all that is a daunting task, but we are moving forward.
Thanks. That's great to hear. Thank you very much.
You're most welcome.